Oh, Hashem. So we're starting a little shiur on the Baba Sali Ziyotzad. And then with the help of Hashem, I hope to start the Mishneh Brura, Hot Shabbat, Smicha program. So many people know the name Baba Sali, Rabbi Yisrael Abuhatzera. But let's start with like what is Baba Sali? Baba Sali, it means the owner of prayer. Why is called the owner of prayer? Because he was very, very famous in the strength of his prayers. People came to him from all over the world to get his prayers. And there's many stories that we can say about people that got many, many salvations on from his prayers and his magnificent spiritual sight that he was able to see on people, all kind of things of what they did wrong and what they should do. And there's many stories about it. I can say one story that I know from someone that was by him, which is the rabbi that I learned Kabbalah by him, Rav Avichai. So Rav Avichai, the Rosh Shiva of Betel Yeshiva, he told me that story that when he was young, he didn't think he's going to be a rabbi. For sure not, he didn't think he was going to be a Rosh Shiva. And he was training to like running, jogging, to go into the army, to special units, whatever it is. And he was going with his friends, and they were like riding. They lived in Yerucham. They were running like by to Netivot, where the Baba Sali was. And one time, one of the people there told him, "Look, there's a big rabbi here. Maybe you want to go to ask a blessing." So imagine yourself, he comes into the line to ask for a blessing, and he's coming with shorts after like jogging, like all like sweating from like jogging, practicing for the army, whatever. So he's standing in line, he gets in, and Baba Sali looks at him, and he tells him, "You have to go to Yerushalayim. There's an old man that is waiting for you to teach you Kabbalah." Like, he didn't think about going to learn Yerushalayim. He didn't think about learning Kabbalah, but that's what the Baba Sali told him. So he was not sure exactly what to do with it. But he said after a while the people told him like how big is the Baba Sali and how important it is to listen to whatever he tells you. So he said, okay, I'll give it a chance. Who knows? And he went to Yerushalayim. And he got into one yeshiva, and he went to a different yeshiva. He thought that the old man that Baba Sali was speaking about was Rav Kaduri. He went to the yeshiva of Rav Kaduri for a little bit. But then he met Rav Getz, Zatzal, that was the previous Rosh Shiva of Betel Yeshiva. There was also the Rosh Shiva of the Kotel. And the moment that they met, so he knew that that was his rabbi, and they basically, like for 10 years and maybe a little bit more, they basically like were together all the time, and he was like the getting is whatever. So the story is not about Rav Avichai, not about the Rav Getz. There's many stories about them as well. But for now, the focus is that the Baba Sali was able to see. Imagine yourself like a young man that comes with shorts, and he tells him like that's his message. So you see from this story, there's many other stories. But you see that he had like a really wonderful ability to see on people like what is really their ability, what is their strength, what is the thing that they need to focus on and to work on themselves. And that's something that I feel personally that it's very, very missing in our generation, that many people have those questions of like what is it that they need to do in their life and so on and so forth. So Bezrat Hashem, I will take the opportunity to say a bracha with the merit of the Baba Sali and the merit of David HaMelech that we're sitting in his next to his grave, that Hashem will have mercy on all of us and send us Mashiach Bezrat Hashem that will lead us in the way of truth and show each one of us, that by the Vilna Gaon, that's the one of the purposes of Mashiach, is to tell each person exactly what is his tikkun, what is his job, what he needs to do in his life. So that's what we're waiting for. But we have a certain idea of how it's going to be like from the Baba Sali and Tzaddikim like that they had some of this ability. Obviously, by Mashiach, it will be much greater. But there was other Tzaddikim, Baruch Hashem, that they had this ability. Anyhow, so that is for one story of the Baba Sali. Once again, I'm sure that whoever is interested, there's tons of stories that people can find. The one thing that I want to add for that before we moving into the Halachot Shabbat, people don't know. They think that his ability was only because of his Kabbalah learning, and so on. But I want to say that he was Dayan. He was like, except of the fact that he was a great huge Mikubal, but he was also Dayan from a very very young age. It was like I don't remember like which age, but like when he was like really young, he was already anointed to that he's qualified to be Dayan, to be like, how would you translate Dayan into English? Like a Torah judge? It doesn't sound very good. Whatever. Like a judge, but according to the Torah laws, let's put it this way. So imagine like, you know, something like, I don't know if he was exactly Bar Mitzvah, but like, I think around like Bar Mitzvah or 18, maybe, very, very young guy, and he was already like anointed to be like that level of a rabbi. That's in the halakha field, obviously. So one thing that I want to say about his Torah learning, that should be a source of inspiration for us, that he was like really pushing himself like to as much as he was able to. And I heard I was learning my smicha by Rav Deri Shlita, so Rav Yudah Deri, the rabbi of Be'er Sheva, used to come here to Har Tzion. So he was Moroccan. So you know the Moroccan Jews, they have many stories about the Baba Sali. So he said that the Baba Sali, when he was young, he had a chevruta, and like in the night, obviously they were learning all day long, but in the night when like they were supposed to sleep, right? But instead of sleeping, so they did shifts. That one is resting, and one is reading, in Zohar or Rishit Chochma, whatever it is. And like when the guy that was supposed to read was like stopping reading, so the other guy would like wake up and like take his shift and continue to read. So they had like and even somehow, even though he was like sleeping, he was able to continue to go over different material. So that's talking about someone that he was very, very dedicated for his Torah learning and like really pushing himself over his limits. Obviously, there's many stories about his fasting days and so on and so forth. So it's a very big, one of the biggest tzaddikim that the world had, as far as we know. Anyhow, that's for that. And Bezrat Hashem, Hashem will help all of us to learn from him and from all of the rest of the tzaddikim to go in on their footsteps and to dedicate ourselves to study the Torah and to go deeper into the Torah. And to have those magnificent abilities of praying for the world and getting all the needs of the world, Bezrat Hashem, to be fulfilled. And with that, I want also to dedicate the class for Fua Shlema for one of my friends that is in the hospital, Yair Ben Sarah, and also Adi Bat Chana, Refua Shlema, and all of the people that needs Refua Shlema. Rav Sekton also, Rav David Ben, you know his mother's name? Rav David, okay. Rav David Ben Sarah and his wife Sarah Bat, I'm not sure, but Sarah. Anyhow, Bezrat Hashem, Refuah Shlema for everybody, and Bezrat Hashem, Hashem will take all of the sickness away from us, and Bezrat Hashem make everybody healthy also spiritually, emotionally, and physically, Bezrat Hashem. So we are in the Smicha program in Halachot Shabbat.